Did Microsoft really just release a new version of SharePoint? Let's dive in and find out what this whole SharePoint Embedded thing is all about. So a few days ago, Microsoft announced SharePoint Embedded. Let's read what the description of this thing is. SharePoint Embedded provides developers a faster way to create file and document-focused applications. SharePoint Embedded is powered by SharePoint. With SharePoint Embedded, developers can integrate the same powerful file and document capabilities that SharePoint has to offer in their own custom applications. So what this thing really is it's SharePoint without any web interface whatsoever. It lets you use any application you develop and have SharePoint's storage mechanisms and protections as backend storage. Let's go through some of the features of this thing, and then I'll give you my thoughts and my big aha moment that really puts all of this into perspective. So it gives you file storage abilities, a file storage system with just no web front end whatsoever. So you're gonna have to develop a front end to this thing, and then you just don't have to worry about where to store files and things like that. It's just all stored in SharePoint. But it's not quite SharePoint. And here's why. One of the features of this headless SharePoint is that the storage is not in your normal SharePoint environment. It's a totally separate environment. Files are not stored on a SharePoint site. But because of this, it also doesn't use up any of your storage quota that's in SharePoint either. On the other hand of that, though, is you're going to be paying for the storage for this thing. It's using a pay-as-you-go model, so that could be a nice trade-off, maybe. Now, one of the big concerns with storing things outside of SharePoint is, well, you've already got everything secured in your environment. You've configured Purview. You configured other security settings to protect the data that's stored in there. And that's actually continued into SharePoint Embedded. You'll still have the same protections that you have within your normal SharePoint environment. So that's a big plus for all of these security administrators out there who would probably just completely outlaw any use of this thing if it had no protection, or if you had to set it up a second time, or for each one of these SharePoint Embedded applications, if you had to reset your security backup, that would be a big showstopper. Now, just because this is staying in a whole different SharePoint, it is all still stored in your Microsoft 365 tenant. So all of your data is still in this nice tight bundle surrounded by all of your security. So that's another big plus to this thing. Traditionally, when you had custom development, it would be stored somewhere else. It might be in a SQL database. It could be in a file share somewhere. It could be in some other third-party solution. And that created inherent problems because you may not have the same level of control in those other environments like you would in Microsoft 365. Keeping everything together is definitely a good thing with this. I think they've taken the right steps for security. So you're going to be building a custom front end with this. How are you going to communicate with SharePoint? Well, you're going to use the Graph API for all storage and retrieval actions. Pretty much anything you want to do with that SharePoint backend, you're going to be using Graph APIs for that. And all of those files that you're storing are in a new type of container that they've released with this called a file storage container. Another key thing is that when you have this SharePoint Embedded hooked up to an application, the only thing that can get that data out is a custom application. You're not going to be able to get this through regular old SharePoint. You could only use your custom front end to retrieve files or add more files to that. That is an important point with this. Now, another thing is that this is not turned on by default. With all tenants, it's going to be disabled by default. You will need to go into the SharePoint Admin Center, and in settings, you'll see the SharePoint Embedded option where you can enable that. Now, one important thing to note about the security settings is that they're only going to apply to documents. I don't know at this point whether lists can be created and stored through this or if it is just documents, but your security settings and stuff from Purview are only going to apply to your documents in SharePoint Embedded. Now let's take a step back and look at this from a higher level view. We kind of saw this coming from a long time ago. If you really think back to how you're using SharePoint and especially Teams, think about how you've got channels in your Teams and you've generally got a files tab. Where are those files stored at? They are stored in SharePoint. but you're not going into SharePoint. In fact, most of my teams, I never ever visit the SharePoint site for that team. I use the Files tab, and I think about it, I'm using Teams as the front end and SharePoint as the back end. We're already doing this. This SharePoint Embedded feature really just takes this one step further. And since you may not need that SharePoint environment, you're going to do everything through Teams, just remove the web interface. That's basically what we've got here, except this takes it one step further because it's a new SharePoint environment. It's that SharePoint Embedded environment. It doesn't use a SharePoint site that I can tell, but it still has all the great benefits of SharePoint's file storage. So the signs were already there that this was the direction they were going to go in, moving away from being in SharePoint day in and day out and starting to use other applications while still leveraging all of the technology that they've built into SharePoint. It really makes sense if you think about it. Now, that was a big aha moment for me when I thought about it from that point of view. If that was an aha moment for you too, click that like button to let me know. And let me know in the comments if you are a developer and you see a lot of uses for this, if you're going to be diving in and checking this thing out. Obviously, you'll need to be a developer to build that front end, but I know a lot of you are developers, so I'd like your thoughts down below and let's talk about it. I've got a link to this announcement in the description below, so make sure to check that out and see all the details that they've released so far. I'm sure we're going to continue to get more news from SharePoint Embedded and see how we can best integrate this into our workspace. If there's somebody you know that needs to know about this information, make sure to share this video with a friend so that everyone can understand what's coming and where things are headed. Thanks for watching. Subscribe to the channel for more content like this.